All right. Hook experimental rapid fire version take one. This intro is basically canon in D. The song is already a meme from Jump by putting one of the most iconic chord progressions of all time as the bed of this song about catchy things. And then, of course, John Popper's gonna go ahead and do his harmonica thing because it's a Blues Traveler tune and it's awesome. Literally doesn't matter what the lyrics of the song are as long as he puts his own particular stank on it. As long as there's emotion in the music itself, then it makes you think that he's saying something enlightening or super deep, but he hasn't said anything so far except for literally narrating your current musical experience, and he could do this all day. And it doesn't matter if you're a casual music listener or if you're a super virtuosic ear, if he's doing it right, then it's going to be super catchy as hell, because all you really got to do is put a musical motif that repeats itself and it's incredibly catchy, and think about it, it's the truth. I'm gonna repeat it again because this is going to be the part of the song that you remember the most, and it kinda works every time. However, there is something up here. I don't feel entirely like I'm telling the truth right now. I'm still gonna go ahead and narrate your experience. In fact, this whole song has kind of been an elaborate lie, but that's kind of cool, and you kind of like that. However, I'm going to go ahead and throw a left curve here, and I'm going to get really weird only in the service of a pun, but it's pretty solid. I'm going to reference Peter Pan here, and I'm going to change the capitalization of the word hook from lowercase h to big H to turn the musical motif into the villain, the hook, as in Captain Hook. Ah! Man, when I was a kid, that absolutely blew my gourd as soon as I got that. And that's probably one of my favorite things in lyrics of all time. Oh, did I mention? We're just going to go ahead and repeat the chorus in a lead up to John Popper doing what John Popper do. And just like any guitar player, a harmonica player will also have some really cool signature licks. And if you listen to a lot of Blues Traveler tunes, you can start to pick out some kind of regular motifs that he likes to do. Very iconic. You hear John Popper play the harmonica and you're like, yep, I know exactly who that is. And I think that's really cool when you can find something like that musically that works for you. This is, of course, a lead-up into one of the fastest, coolest things that I ever sing. We're gonna start with a little bit of fast nonsense and in a bit of desperation because I feel like I'm revealing too much, and this exposure that I'm getting through MTV and having a music video is really, really cool, but I feel like it comes at the expense of my artistic expression, and it might be financial suicide for me to be pulling back the curtain this far, but I feel like this is the only way that I can balance writing catchy little tunes and quick 3-minute ditties with feeling like I'm actually saying something. And I kind of want to tear down all of your expectations of what pop music is and means. So even if I'm saying all of this, well, at least I still have the hook. And it brings you back, and I feel like this is one of the most honest things I've ever done, and yet I've packaged it in the most dishonest rapper, but it works, man.